Hello, and welcome to IT Convergence's User Productivity Kit tutorial series. This is a demonstration of how to export and import content using the Oracle UPK Developer. The export and import functionality of the UPK Developer allows you to exchange content between libraries and database servers and create backup copies of your content. You can choose to export a single document or folder, a selection or related documents, a collection of folders, or an entire library. The export process creates a single archive file that contains all the documents included in the selection. Import adds all of the content of an archive file to your library, including the folder structure. This functionality, offered by UPK, allows you to deliver content to clients, share content among developers, modify publishing styles, localize content, share content defaults, share sound files, and prepare a backup archive of current content. To export content from the library or outline editor, select the folders and/or documents you want to export. For the purpose of this tutorial, we are going to use the folder Great Features of the UPK from the outline editor. On the Tools menu, point to Export and choose Documents. The next step is to set the export options, which are: select the location in which to save the export archive and specify the name of the archive file. In this example, I am going to save it to Tutorial Export Content and title it Great Features of the UPK. Click Save. Then select between the options Export Your Selection Only or Your Selection and All Related Documents. In this example, I am going to use Selection and All Related Documents. Click Export to execute the process. The export tool analyzes the processes and selects the documents, creating a single archive file with the specified location. To import content, point to Import and choose Documents in the Tools menu. Set the import options, which are: select the archive you want to import. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm going to use the same content we just exported. Going to Tutorial Export Content and selecting the file Great Features of the UPK. Next, specify the library location into which the contents of the archive are to be imported. In this example, I'm going to use the test folder in the library. Lastly, there will be an option to overwrite existing documents or not. Choose the overwrite option if the archive contains updated versions of documents that are already in your library. Choose not to overwrite existing documents to import only new documents from an archive containing some documents that are new and some that are already present in your library. For the purpose of this tutorial, I'm not going to select overwrite existing documents. Click Import to execute the process. The import tool analyzes and processes the selected archive, adding the archive documents and recreating their relative folder structure in the specified library folder. The results of importing an archive depend on the contents of the archive, the existing contents and structure of the library, and the specified import options. This concludes our tutorial on how to export and import content using the Oracle UPK Developer. On behalf of IT Convergence, I would like to thank you for your time and invite you to join IT Convergence's YouTube channel, where you can learn more about the User Productivity Kit features and functions.